students, these days we are discussing about our lesson number first, physical quantities and measurements. Welcome back. Today's our topic is measurement of volume of an irregular body. Those who have the book, please open your book. Others, please go through the video. Measurement of volume of an irregular body. The volume of a solid of irregular shape can be measured by using a measuring cylinder by the method of displacement of liquid. Each body occupies space equal to its own volume. Therefore, if a body of irregular shape is immersed in a liquid, it displaces the volume of liquid equal to its own volume so as to occupy the space of liquid. Thus, volume of a body of irregular shape is equal to volume of liquid displaced by the body when it is immersed completely to the liquid. So we can say that volume of a body of irregular shape is equal volume of liquid displaced by the body when it is immersed completely into the liquid. To find the volume of the displaced liquid, we note the initial level of liquid in measuring cylinder and then the level of liquid after immersing the given body completely into the liquid inside the measuring cylinder. First of all, what we have to do once again, to find the volume of the displaced liquid, we note the initial level of the liquid in measuring cylinder and then the level of liquid after immersing the given body completely into the liquid inside the measuring cylinder. The difference in the final level from the initial level gives the volume of the liquid displaced, which is equal to the volume of the given regular body. This can be demonstrated by the following activity. You go through this activity, it's very simple activity. Take a piece of stone, a measuring cylinder, fine thread of the sufficient length and some water. Place a measuring cylinder on a flat horizontal surface and fill it partially with water. Note the reading V1 of the water level very carefully. The water level is now V1. Now tie the piece of stone with a thread and dip it completely into water. We see that the level of water rises. Note the reading V2 of the water level. The diagram of the arrangement is given here. Please observe it. Okay. The difference in the two levels of water gives the volume of the piece of stone. So what we have to do to find out the answer, initial level of water V1 is equal to, suppose, 60 ml in the diagram. Then level of water when stone is immersed, V2, is equal to 80 ml. We can see in the diagram. volume of water displaced is equal to V2 minus V1. Okay, volume of water displaced is equal to V2 minus V1. So our measurements are 80 and 60. V2 is 80 ml, 60 is V1, then minus 80 ml minus 60 ml. We are getting the answer 20 ml. That's why volume of the piece of stone is equal to 80 minus 60 ml is equal to 20 ml. That is equal to 20 centimeter cube. Why? Because 1 ml is equal to 1 centimeter cube. Okay. The volume of an empty vessel like a bottle can be found by filling it completely with water and then pouring the water in a clean measuring cylinder. So this is the activity to find out the volume of an irregular body. Now we have the topic area. We have learned in class 6 that surface occupied by an object is called its area. The SI unit of area is square meter. Symbol is meter square. The SI unit of area is square meter. Its symbol is meter square. It is equal to the area of a square of side 1 meter. 1 meter square is equal to 1 meter into 1 meter. To express the area of a playground, a football field, a village or a town, square meter is a small unit. The bigger unit of area are given here. That is square decameter or R or hectare and square kilometer. Square decameter, hectare and a square kilometer. Is the area of a square with each side measuring 10 meter, when R is the area of a square with which each side measuring 10 meter, when R is equal to 10 meter into 10 meter is equal to 100 meter square. Same way, 1 hectare is the area of a square with each side measuring 100 meter. That is, 1 hectare is equal to 100 into 100, 10,000 meter square. That can be written as 10 raised to 4 meter square, 100 earth. 100 earth is equal to 1 hectare. 1 square kilometer is the area of a square with which each side measuring 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer square is equal to 1 kilometer into 1 kilometer. That is 1000 into 1000 meter is equal to 10 raised to meter square. On the other hand, to express the area of small objects like pencil, rubber, etc., square meter is a big unit. The smaller units of area are square centimeter or square millimeter. The symbols are centimeter square and millimeter square. 1 centimeter square is equal to 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. That is equal to 1/100 meter into 1/100 meter is equal to 10^-4 meter square. 1 centimeter square is equal to 10^-4 meter square. So please keep in your mind these points, because these digits we need for the numericals. For the solution of numericals, these equations, these digits are very important. Now 1 millimeter square is equal to 10^-6 meter square. Thus, the units of area are related as 1 ar is equal to 10^2 meter square. 1 hectare is equal to 10^4 meter square. 1 kilometer square is equal to 10^6 meter square. 1 centimeter square is equal to 10^-4 meter square. 1 millimeter square is equal to 10^-8 meter square. Okay. Now we'll discuss about measurement of area of regular object. The area of a regular object can be found by measuring the two dimensions, that is length, breadth or radius of the object, and using the following relations as applicable. Area of square is equal to 1 side square. Area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Area of circle is equal to pi into radius square. Surface area of cylinder is equal to 2 pi into radius into length. 2 pi into radius into length. Surface area of sphere is equal to 4 pi into radius square, where pi is equal to 3.14 or 22/7. Now we will discuss about measurement of area of an irregular object. To estimate the area of an irregular object or lamina, graph paper is used. It is a sheet of paper on which horizontal and vertical lines are ruled at a regular interval of 1 millimeter. Graph paper is a sheet of paper on which horizontal and vertical lines are ruled at a regular interval of 1 millimeter. The lines showing the spacing of 1 centimeter between them are made thick. Then the area of one big square becomes 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter is equal to 1 centimeter square. While the area of one small square is 1 millimeter into 1 millimeter is equal to 1 millimeter square. The graph paper is shown in figure 1.8. You can see it. This is the graph paper. Okay, this is the graph paper. Okay, we can continue our activity here. Activity 3. Place an irregular object on a graph sheet. Draw an outline of the object and remove it. First, count the number of complete squares. Then count the number of incomplete squares which are half. And more than, okay, more than half within the outline. Ignore the squares which are less than half within the outline. The sum of the areas of the number of complete squares and the number of incomplete squares gives the approximate area of the irregular object. Okay. Number of complete squares marked as tick is equal to here in the graph sheet, that is 4. Number of complete squares marked as dot, that is equal to 4. Total number of squares n is equal to 4 plus 4, that is equal to 8. Area of an irregular object is 8 into 1 centimeter square, that is equal to 8 centimeter square. The approximate area of the given object is 8 centimeter square. So here is an interesting fact, do you know? You may be asked to find out the volume of an irregular sheet of finite thickness. For this, find the area of by using graph paper and thickness by meter ruler. Then use the relation volume is equal to area into thickness. So now our next topic is density. Our next topic is density. This we'll discuss tomorrow. Okay, students, I hope today's portion is understood. Okay, study carefully, learn carefully, and watch the videos. Stay safe, stay home, and goodbye.